Okay, let us see a concept. Magnetic field is given like this. It is out of page, and we have, let us say, a wire. Okay, this is the cutoff point. This wire length is, let us say, L, and I take a charge Q on the wire. Now initially the charge Q is in rest. When the charge Q is in rest, will there be any magnetic force on that? No, because magnetic force, we have learned that it is Q into P cross B. So what is the angle between, if at all I let us say I push the wire like this with some velocity V. This velocity V and magnetic field B, what will be the angle between them? Theta will be 90 degrees. So when you expand this, this force vector magnitude will be QVB sine theta, but theta is 90, so this will be basically QVB only, magnitude of the force vector. This is the magnetic force. So when you move the wire, the charge on the wire also will move, so it will experience a magnetic force given like this. So what will be the direction of current? There will be an induced current in this. So we can apply, we can say that, will there be a current induced in this? Let us try to question at fundamental level. Now the charge is here, this charge will be experiencing the magnetic force. What will be the direction of the magnetic force? You can use the right hand rule. So if you can show it like this, this middle finger is pointing out of the page, this index finger is pointing the direction of velocity, then this thumb will point the direction of the magnetic force. So this will be experiencing a magnetic force in this direction. Obviously, when there is a magnetic force in this direction, the charge will move, it will be accelerated. So from here it will reach here. So the movement of charge is basically current. If you know the time in which it travels from here to here, then charge by time will give you current. What type of current is this? This is induced current. Had there been no movement of the charge, there wouldn't have been any current. Okay, so this is induced current. Now here, if the charge is moving from this point to this point, there must be some work done. So work at, and what is the condition of work done? You write work is equal to F dot S. This force and displacement vector should be in the same direction. So from here to here the charge is moving, so the work done will be equal to force into distance traveled, so it is L. But what is the force? Force is equal to this, so it is QVB L. Let me bring this Q the other side, then W by Q is equal to BLV. What is this term? Work done per unit charge. If I take the charge on the other side, then it is the total work done in moving a unit charge. Is it not the definition of EMF what we have learned in current electricity chapter? So this induced EMF will be equal to BLV. So if the charge is moving from this point to this point, there must be a potential difference, which is because of which only it is moving. In the case of a DC circuit, you know, when you draw a DC circuit, you are saying that there is a potential difference. This is positive terminal, negative terminal. Because of the charge, the electron will move in this direction from negative to positive, but the conventional direction of current, we will take it as positive to negative. So here there is a potential difference because of which the charge is moving. So here also analogous, there must be a potential difference. That's why the charge is moving from here to here, and thereby the current is induced. So this is another explanation of how motional EMF is produced.